has more than 10 years of working experience. Her core experience is in training, quality, and sales. Her top strengths are innovation, execution, consulting, communication, focus, goal-oriented, and much more. So here we have gigantic opportunity to learn from Ms. Komal Vadhwan. So now Ms. Komal, it's all over to you. Thank you so much.
Thanks, Shruti, for this lovely introduction. And I'm glad to be a part of this event. So as Ricky has already introduced me that this is Komal Vadhwan and I get an experience of more than 10 years in training, quality, sales. Plus, I am a motivational speaker. I am also a life coach. I host events, especially the virtual ones due to COVID-19 situation that we all are in. So I welcome you all in this session. So to make it interactive, what we can do is that we will have a Q&A session in the end, but in between, if you feel like that there is some gap or you want to understand more, then you can just, pitch in and you can tell me if you want any clarification, or else we can wait for the end, right? So before I start with this, presentation, I would like to know, you all, I just need your 30 seconds in introduction, not more than that. I just need your name and the kind of experience you carry. If you're a fresher, you can say I'm a fresher, or else you can say I'm experienced, and plus the qualification that you have. So let's start with somebody with the name of 2020 has joined. So that is a very, interesting name. So who is 2020? Can you unmute yourself and introduce yourself? So 2020, Mr. I can see you have already unmuted yourself. Okay, I think so that it's facing some issue. Then we have Abhirami. Yes.
Hi, ma'am.
Hi. So yes, you can tell me about yourself, experience. Are you a fresher?
I'm both in MBA in Chennai, ma'am. First time I'm a fresher, ma'am.
Okay, that's lovely. Thank you. Then we have Devendra Kumar.
Hello, I'm audible?
Yes, you are.
Yes, so my name is Devendra Kumar and currently I'm pursuing MBA in HR domain from IMS Indore. And yes, it's all about me.
Okay, thank you, Devendra. Then we have Dr. Dheeraj Tiwari.
Hello.
Yes, you are audible.
I'm Dr. Dheeraj Tiwari. Actually, I am faculty for marketing. And I am teaching marketing subjects to Govindram Saxeria in Govindram Saxeria Institute of Management and Research in Law.
Okay, thank you. Let's move on to Komal Lal. Komal, can you hear us? Okay, let's move on to Navneet. I think so Komal is facing some issue. Navneet?
Hello, ma'am. My name is Navneet. I'm pursuing master's from Amity University, Mumbai in advertising and public relations. And I'm a fresher. Okay. That's it, ma'am. Thank you.
Thank you. Ritika Raj.
Hi, good evening, ma'am. My name is Ritika Raj. I have graduated in aerospace engineering from Dehradun. And I have 6 months of experience in sales and marketing in an education sector company, Extra Marks Education India Private Limited. And currently, I'm pursuing a master's in business administration in aviation business management from Bangalore.
Okay, great. Thank you, Ritika. Ritu, over to you now. Yes, Ritu.
Hello, ma'am. Ma'am, this is Ritu.
Yeah.
I'm from Haldwani, from Uttarakhand. Right now, I'm in Karam Industries, Sitarganj. Basically, Farm industry procure PPE products. So I'm still working here from last two years.
Okay, okay. Thanks, Ritu. Sakshi Priya.
Hello, good evening, ma'am.
Good evening.
I am Sakshi Priya. I am pursuing master's from Vanasthali Vidyapeeth and I am pursuing MBA from HR and Marketing.
Okay.
That's all, ma'am.
Okay, thanks. Sanya.
Thank you.
Good evening, ma'am.
Good evening.
Myself, Sani Aslal, I'm from Kerala. I'm a BBA graduate and currently pursuing MBA, specialized in finance and HR. And I had worked as an HR associate intern at MWH Holdings for 2 months and as finance intern at Mithila Iconic Art for 1 month. That's all, ma'am. Thank you.
Thanks, Sakshi. Shubham. Shubham Anand.
Hello, ma'am.
Hi.
Hello, myself Shubham Anand. I'm from Mandsaur. Currently, I'm pursuing MBA in HR domain from IMS Indore. And I am fresher now. That's all about me. Thank you.
Okay, thanks. Let's move on to Virender.
Hello, ma'am.
Hello, yes.
I am Virender Singh Nair. Currently, I am pursuing MBA in marketing and operation specialization. And now I am digital marketing intern at Rolletta Technology, where I am team leader. And that's all about me.
Okay, thank you so much, everyone. Thanks, Virender. Thank you, everyone, for introducing yourself. So I can see that some of you have some experience of, some domains and some are freshers. So it is nice to start with this particular topic because this is very close to my heart because wherever I have worked so far, I have seen my MDs, my directors, even though the managers or the top level management is facing issues with their employees by not following the basic email etiquette. It's not a rocket science. It is just that when we talk about emails, this is something which is a written communication, which is a part of written communication. We can correlate it with the letters that we used to write in, few years back. Letters had a very, a huge respect that people should write letter if in case you want to apply somewhere or if you want to, register a complaint, you need to write a letter. But nowadays, people are moving to social media and people are moving towards emails because it is very easy that you can use it. But today I'm going to talk more about the professional, the business email etiquette that when you join an organization, what all things you should keep it in your mind while writing an email. So let me just move on this slide to see that what we are going to learn today. We are going to understand the importance and benefits of emails, email etiquette, plus what are the do's and don'ts of writing an email. These are some of the points that we are going to discuss. When I started my career, nobody told me. So I did a lot of mistakes and I learned from my mistakes. But by God's grace, I was into training and development. So, I researched a lot. I Googled things. I saw a lot of videos to understand that what all things we should keep it in our mind. And plus, I got feedback from my managers. So I've realized that most of the organizations are not covering this topic as a basic topic that should be taught in inductions. But I think so that it should be covered. So when we talk about email etiquette, email etiquette means that the code of conduct of writing emails, what all things we have to, keep it in our mind so that it should look professional rather than it should look casual, chit-chat kind of thing. So when you, send a WhatsApp to someone, you write, hi, WhatsApp, let's meet today, yaar, or dost, or some, such kind of slangs we use usually when we are writing on WhatsApp or we are chit-chatting with our friends or family members. Same is with your Facebook as a platform or Twitter. So democracy is there and you can write anything and everything that you like. But when you are in a corporate, when you are writing a business email, you need to make sure that you're following basic rules of writing an email. So let's move on to the next slide. So what are the benefits of, emails? So it is like more personal direct medium of communication. So it means that if you want to write something to someone rather than, picking up a paper and pen and writing something and then, using speed post to deliver that letter. So it is better to write email. It will take few seconds or milliseconds sometimes to send your email and the recipient will receive it within fractions of seconds. Obviously, second point I have covered here. Next is that you can allow yourself to save a copy of the email that you have sent as a proof. So if I talk about, a complaint, suppose I wrote a complaint to LG, I was facing some issue with LG split AC, suppose, and I write an email to LG. And they replied to me stating that, we have not received any of your email. So I can, forward the previous email that I have sent to their email ID, customer care email ID, and as a proof that, yes, I have sent it earlier. So you can keep a record of your communication. It was just an example that I have shared with you. Plus, there is no time constraint. You are not restricted from 9 to 6 or, 10 to 7 that, these are the timings you have to follow. You can write an email at 12 a.m. in the night, or you can write an email at 2 a.m. in the night. That's totally okay because it is so handy and so quick that you need not to wait for the next day to come and you need not to wait for the official hours. So it is available 24/7 to you. Plus, if in case you want to send communication to many people around, so you can send emails. So if I take a recent example of Arogya Setu app, so whosoever had email IDs in India, Pradhan Mantri's marketing team actually picked up all those email IDs and sent email to everyone regarding Arogya Setu app that you should download it to track COVID-19. So it was a very easy, medium of written communication that was sent to almost every Indian that you should download this app. Or else they can go to radio or they can go to, live TV shows. But emails are something like which is documented and it can be kept as a reminder that, okay, I need to do something like this, which has been sent over the email. You can attach documents, you can attach images, you can attach PPTs, you can attach almost anything that your, email provider actually allows. So if I talk about Gmail, maybe the Gmail is allowing you to send maximum of 20 MB file, but maybe your organization will allow you only 2 MB. So it totally depends upon the company that you're working with or the email provider, service provider you're using the email ID of. You can access email from anywhere, anytime that we have already discussed. So there is no restriction. It's a easiest mode of sending a communication. So now let's move on to the principles of writing email. So there is a reason of having 2 and CCs in your emails. So when I talk about 2 and CCs, so what is the difference between 2 CC and BCC? Let me give you an example here. So suppose I want to take a leave and I want to, send it to my boss. So my boss is my MD. So I write a mail to my MD stating that, hi, sir, due to some reason, I need a leave for today. So I will keep him in 2 because I'm addressing this mail directly to him and I'm looking forward to some action, right? So I will keep him in 2. Now, if I talk about his secretary, so his secretary actually keeps a record of, all these emails. So I can keep her in CC as a FYI for your information kind of stuff that, okay, I'm on a leave. I have sent an email to my boss, but I'm keeping the secretary in the CC so that she can keep a record of the same. Let me take another example. So suppose I want to escalate something to a person, right? And there is a boss also, which is involved, which I want to involve or include in this email. So what I can do is that I can directly write an email to that person from whom I'm looking forward to a solution. And I can keep his or her boss in CC so that his or her boss knows that some escalation has come and my team has to work on it, right? Obviously, I'm not expecting a direct reply from the person who I have kept in CC, but he or she should know that what is happening in the world, right? So that's how you can write an email. So from the two, the person you have kept in two, you will expect a reply from that person, right? You can expect an action plan or the action or solution on that particular case that you have highlighted over an email. Plus, when I say CC, so CC may, you can keep all those people whom you want to give an information that, okay, this is what is happening and this is for your information, right? So let's move on to the next point, which is subject. I guess I've seen, even though my team, if I talk about my team, sometimes they forget, you know, writing subject, and I just scold them, because subject is something which will give a glimpse, of the email body, right? So subject is extremely important. Plus, your subject should be short and crisp and to the point. Rather than writing the whole story in the subject, you can just keep it very short and simple. For example, again, I will take an example of leave. So I can, you know, just write regarding leave application or regarding leave. I can just write it like that in the subject, rather than writing the whole scenario regarding leave application because I'm not well. So that you can, you know, write it in the email body rather than writing it in the subject. So the subject should be very crisp, short, and to the point, so that the recipient can understand, okay, you know, something related to this is there in the email. So the subject should correlate with the body of the email. Now the next point is greet the recipient with hi or dear. Now this is again, you know, very important, because on daily basis, if I talk about myself, I'm sending around 30 to 40 emails on daily basis. So the emails cannot, you know, show your emotions. Maybe you are in a very good, mood, and you're writing that email, but the recipient is not in a good mood. So he will take that email as per his or her mood. He will not consider your mood in the, you know, through the email, because you cannot express your emotions through emails, through written communication. It is very difficult to express your feelings. So it is important that you use the salutation to, you know, to greet the recipient. It's important. If somebody writes, you know, like this on the email, Komal, why have you not done this? Komal, I'm expecting a reply on this. So it is a kind of a direct communication, which can even sound rude to me, because again, I can't understand the emotions of the sender, and as a recipient, I can take it otherwise. I can take it in a negative way, and I can say, okay, I will take a revenge now that how this person can write an email to me like that. So it is better that you greet the recipient with hi, dear, hi with the last name. For example, you want to address me, so you can either write hi Komal, or else if you don't know me yet, and if you want to use my last name, so you can write like hi Miss Vadhavan. So that is absolutely okay in the communication, but avoid using hey, hello. So these are some, you know, casual words that we should avoid using it in business email like writing. So I've given you some examples here, like dear Miss Sharma, hi Sumit, hi sir, dear ma'am. So ma'am, this is the right form of writing the word, which is ma'am, in a short form. Some people write it as ma'am. That is absolutely a, you know, big no, you know, writing ma'am like that. This is the right and appropriate way of writing ma'am. So subject is important, greeting is important. Let's move on to the next point, which is do not write the entire email in bold or uppercase or lots of question marks. And some people also write it in lower cases. So, you know, all these things actually are the signs of rude mails, or, you know, you're lazy, or it's sometimes if somebody, you know, writes it in lower cases, some people actually assume that this person is not that educated. So avoid using bold for every word. Uppercase, when we talk about the caps, so first letter of the word can be in capital when you start the sentence, and then you can write it in lowercase. And when you write a lot of question marks or exclamatory, you know, signs, so again, it is not a sign of maturity or mature email writing, right? So next is choose right color for writing emails. So when it comes to color, again, color has its own importance. So we prefer, in my career, I'm teaching everyone, training everyone, writing emails in navy blue color or black color. Some people have seen that if their work is not getting done on time, then they start writing it in red and bolds and a lot of question marks. So it is a sign of rudeness. So it should be avoided as much as possible. You can use other colors, red, pink, green, any color you can use if you're writing marketing emails or the communication which is sent by the HR for some engagement activities or some, you know, functions. And also for that, they can use these colors. But for normal, professional emails, this is a big, big no. Using red color especially, it is a big no. Then if you have any sensitive information, for example, passwords, so avoid writing emails for that, because always remember that you are giving a copy to someone who can keep it with them throughout their life. So it is better to, you know, give confidential information, maybe one-to-one or maybe over the call if required, and avoid writing it over the email until it is a very, if it is a very sensitive information. Then let's talk about abbreviations and emoticons. So I have seen people using smileys, angry smiley and other type of smiley. There are a lot of smileys. I can't name all of them. So we should avoid that as much as possible. Plus the abbreviations, for example, PFB. If you have ever seen, professional emails, so some people write it as PFB. If I elaborate it, so it is like, please find below, like PFA, please find attach. So it is okay to write some abbreviations with your juniors, but with your seniors or with, the people who you don't know much, it is not at all appropriate to write PFA or PFB kind of slangs, FIA and A, for your information and action. So such kind of abbreviation should be avoided if you don't know that person very well and this is the first time you're going to talk to that person over email. So make it more sophisticated, I would say. So do not send or forward spam emails. So we get a lot of spam emails. So here I'm not talking about the lottery emails only, but I'm talking about the emails people send on daily basis. Sometimes some people have that habit of wishing everyone good morning, and then some images of God is there in the professional emails. So we should avoid that as much as possible, because ultimately it is going to add some GBs or MBs in the Outlook, if you're using, or the Gmail you're using. So we should avoid that and avoid distracting people unnecessarily. But one-to-one, we can talk to them. One-to-one, we can wish them for sure. Now, the another pain area that I have realized in my career is reply to all. So reply to all is never recommended. Why? Because there are many people sometimes in the mail, but you are not actually connected to those people, but you're replying to all. Sometimes just to show your status or just to show that I have done this task. So we always say that never use reply to all until unless everyone in that email are important for you in order to get a reply or in order to make them aware of the situation. Then you can use reply to all. Otherwise, avoid using it, or you can write one-to-one email to that person who is like connected to that. To that solution or the action plan that you are going to share. So make sure that you do not use reply to all unnecessarily. I have seen people writing, using reply to all, wishing everyone, just like wishing everyone, happy birthday, even though the one person had birthday on that day, but replying to all. So unnecessarily it is distracting and adding, or occupying space of your email service provider. Then we have, avoid unnecessary trail mails and avoid discussing personal information. So the things which can be sorted out one-to-one, it is not recommended to stretch it and writing, trail mails are going on and there is no solution that you have got. So if in case your work is getting stuck somewhere, you can pick up the phone, you can call that person, you can talk to that person, you can meet that person face to face. You can talk to him and get the problems resolved, whatever you are facing. Then we have proofread your emails. The grammar, punctuation, capitalization, all these things are important for your emails, because since starting of this program, I'm saying that you're going to send a copy to the person. So your grammar should be good. Your punctuation should be right. It is not, we all are not perfect in English. So you can use Grammarly. You can use Grammarly. It's a kind of a tool that you can find it on Google. Plus, you can also spell check this Outlook, or Gmail also gives you option of spell check. You can check the spelling, if there is any mistake, that you can rectify it then and there. Or else if you're facing still some issue in sentence formation or construction, then you can, you know, copy paste your entire mail to Grammarly or check spelling kind of stuff that you can get on Google. And then you can, you know, send that email, because ultimately, your image is totally dependent upon the type of email you're going to send in your corporate life, right? Then acknowledge the emails. If any email has come to you directly wherein the other person is looking forward to some solution or some action, then you can reply on that email by stating that, thanks for the email, or I have received your email. I will get back to you within 24 to 48 hours, or within 2 hours or 4 hours, according to your bandwidth and the turnaround time which you think that it will take. Then signature is extremely important. Signature should consist of thanks and regards kind of thing, and then your full name, your designation. Some people also add their entire company's address, their work number, their landline number. So all these things are included. And nowadays, people are also adding social media handles of their organization in the signature. So all these things are important when it comes to email etiquette. So these are the basic principles that I was talking about. So remember that when you send an email to someone, they're getting a copy that they can keep forever. So we have to be very sure when we are sending an email, especially if you are sharing some sensitive information which can, you know, come back to us at any point of time. So we should be aware of it, and we should always remember that our written communication should be appropriate, with the right verbiages are used, punctuation mark, subject, everything should be there. So that's it I have for you all for today. If you have any questions, then you can ask. I can see some chats are happening. Okay, so that is something between Virender and the team. Okay, so if you have any question, you can unmute yourself one by one and you can ask.
Hello?
Yes.
Ma'am, I have a question. Like, when we use exclamation sign.
Okay.
And I don't know when we have to use, or what is the meaning of that sign in mail, or some people used to send this in WhatsApp also. And what is the use of that sign?
Okay. So this particular sign is usually used for excitement. If you're excited to do something or excited to get some information, then you use it. But in professional emails, we often says that please avoid using this sign. Rather than using full stop is good, or not using anything is better. I can say that.
Okay. That's why I got confused. As I have
said, in WhatsApp, obviously, because it is a more of casual talks that you're doing, and a lot of forwarded messages you must be receiving. So that is okay in casual conversations.
Okay. Thank you so much. I was confused about this. And one more question I have, whenever we have an email ID, we used to write @gmail.com. But right. Some of the IDs are having, if we take an example of in our company also, there it is written @aviation.com. Then right. What is the difference in between these two email IDs?
Okay, so Gmail, when you talk about it, again, it's a Google provided email address. And when you talk about the corporate, the company you're working with, aviation.com, so every company has their own domains. So they use their own domain in case of sending, professional emails, and they have the copies of your emails on their server. So maximum corporates are using their own domain rather than using Gmail or Yahoo Mail or Ymail kind of thing, because that is not a professional platform of you know, sending emails.
Okay, so one, is it safe to send password in these kind of domains, like as this its domain or its server is our company's only?
Look, every company has a server of your emails, and they may keep a copy of your email. So we recommend to avoid it as much as possible.
Okay, thank you.
Yeah. Okay, I've got one chat. Yes, yes. Somebody is saying something.
I'm Dr. Dheeraj.
Yes, yes.
Is there any length limitation for the email while writing an official mail? Like if I am applying for some post, is there any length limit for email
for different people? Yes. So as you have given one example that if you're applying for a job, right, some post. So in that case, obviously, you need to give a cover letter wherein you can write some, you know, major points or major achievements of your entire career that you can mention. But again, it should be short and crisp that the recruiter can read it in like one glance, and they can just, you know, go ahead with the attachment and they can go through your resume. Because if you will write a long story, they are actually, if I talk about me, I'm really not interested in reading long stories. I just need a little bit of introduction and that's sufficient. So have you ever heard about elevator speech? Anyone? Anyone, Shubham, Komal, Virender, Neha, have you ever heard about elevator speech? Tanya, Navneet, Sakshi, Dr. Dheeraj?
No, ma'am. I heard this word elevator speech, but...
okay, no issues. Let me give you, you know, some insights of it. So... you must have heard about startups. You know, a lot of youngsters are coming up with startups nowadays. They want to get funding, right?
I think it's a marketing term. You have to explain in 52 seconds, elevator speech.
Yes, yes.
It is used.
Yes, so I was about to come to that point. So you have already spoke about it. So, you know, these people who are new in the market and who wants to get some funding for their, you know, business, if they want to start it. So they only get, you know, some seconds to introduce their product to the investors. And if the investors like it, then they will invest in that particular business. You won't believe it is below 1 minute that you have to speak. That is elevator speech. So elevator speech means neeche se upar tak jab tak pahunche ya first floor tak tab tak ke liye aapko speech dena hai. That's it. You don't have that much of time and you cannot borrow more time. That is the only time you get, and you have to, you know, give your best shot. So the same is with your emails. Aapki emails may be, aap chahe one liner likhe, two liners likhe, five liners likhe, not more than that, but be very specific to the point and write it in a professional way so that the other person can understand it very well.
Okay.
Yeah.
I also want to ask one question.
Yeah.
My question is this. I'm really sorry I can't put on my camera because I am facing technical issues. So I want to ask that I have studied about 7 C's of communication. That is correct, complete, concrete, concise, consideration, clear, and courteous, right? So I just want to know that how we are going to apply the 7 C's in our email etiquette. And is it possible to apply or not?
Okay.
Thank you.
Thanks for the question, Ricky. So you cannot, I think so, you cannot apply all of these, you know, things in your every email, because sometimes you may have to empathize or sometimes you may not have to empathize. So you can use it in your verbal communication or the written communication, but all of these, I think so, if you even try, all of these cannot be considered in all the emails. Again, I will quote it with an example. So suppose I wrote a first mail to my junior asking for a particular project plan. So yeah. I wrote an email to that person and he replied to me next day, okay, ma'am, I'm working on it and I will get back to you within a day or so. I got the deadline and I was waiting for another 1 or 2 days. But again, I haven't got any reply. So I will write an email to him. What is the status? XYZ, what is the status of this particular task? Have you completed it? Obviously, I cannot, be very courteous at that point of time or very, lenient because I want to get the work done. So these, 7 C's are not possible every time, but yes, we can try the utilization of all these as much as possible. But okay. Every time it is not possible.
Definitely. Thank you so much.
Yeah, you're welcome.
Hello.
Yes.
Ma'am, can you hear me, ma'am?
Hello. Yes, Virendra.
Ma'am, my question is, how much words or character is enough for an ideal email?
Sorry, what are the?
My question is, how much character or words are paragraph enough for an ideal email to write?
So again, it depends upon the length of one paragraph. Tell my people to do is to write not more than 2 to 3 paragraphs consisting of only 1 to 2 sentences each paragraph. Because again, when this your email becomes a kind of a story to read, nobody has that much of time. So make it as short as possible and to the point.
Yeah, ma'am.
So 2 to 3 paragraphs with 1 to 2 or maximum 3 sentences in each paragraph are okay. Not more than that.
It is good to write it point-wise rather than paragraphs.
Yes. So suppose you want to ask for some stuff for someone. So you can write it like that. List of the items are mentioned below. And then 0.1, 0.2, 0.3, 0.4. So bullets and the pointers are better than writing a big story.
Okay. Big thank you, ma'am.
Yeah, you're welcome. Same is with the presentations also.
Yeah, ma'am.
Okay. In professionalism, is that okay to reply back as like in chat process or it should be proper? Okay. So when you chat with someone, you write it like K. Okay ko aap K likh dete hain. Then there are some more words that you use, LOL kind of stuff. So the words or the slangs that you use in your normal chat conversation is a big no in your professional emails. It is better to write full words, which English vocabulary has given us. That is the best thing to do. I've answered Neha's question and I've got one more question from Devendra, how to approach someone for something professionally. So maybe tomorrow if you want to start your own business and you want to write a proposal, so in that case, you can start, writing like, hi Komal, hope everything is fine at your end during this COVID-19 situation. So I would like to throw your attention towards the business plan that we have or to the product that we are into. And then you can write some, 3, 4, 5 bullets and you can, list down all the USPs, unique selling points of your business. So that's how you can approach the person professionally, and the signature is must, signature with subject. Yeah, any more questions? Because I think so I've already exceeded the time. Okay. So Ricky, I think so we are done with the session and
at the end of this session, I would like to welcome Ms. Poonam for a vote of thanks. Thank you so much for the great session.
Thank you, Ricky, for inviting me. And thank you so much, ma'am, for enlightening us with the major and minor things which we should take care in our corporate life. And especially thank you for giving me this site, which is Grammarly, for checking our grammar. And thank you so much from the behalf of the whole Air Cruise Aviation Private Limited. Thank you so much.
Welcome, Poonam. Thank you so much for these words. It means a lot to me. Thank you, everyone. Thank you so much. Thank you.
Thank you.